It's out of science fiction, but you can kind of see it. So explain the basics of the technology, how this would work.
Yeah, so thanks for having me on. Like I said, the name of the company is Aetherflux, and the mission is to take this idea of space solar power, which is an old NASA Department of Energy idea, and make it a real-life thing. And the basic concept is you collect solar power in orbit, and by doing so, you're able to beam it down to locations virtually globally, and by doing so, address a lot of the limitations of renewable energy and the intermittency.
To address what the audience might be wondering, I know you as one of the co-founders of Robinhood. Your background, though, is in physics. You have a family tied to NASA.
Yeah.
How did this company come about?
Yeah, so my love of physics and space industry actually goes back really long. So I grew up with my dad studying physics in the United States. He worked at NASA as when I was a kid. And I studied physics and math at Stanford. And so I've kind of had a love of the space industry from childhood. And through building Robinhood, the passion for looking for commercial opportunities in space, how can we make space technology useful for people on Earth, has kind of been a love of mine for a long time. And in particular, asking the question about how can we bring natural resources from space down to Earth, and I think energy is one of the natural choices for that.
Bringing it down from space to Earth. You said beam it down. Like, get into the nitty-gritty. How does one beam it down?
Yeah, so the way that we're going to be transferring power from space to Earth is actually using a constellation of satellites in low Earth orbit, and each one collects power and then uses infrared lasers to find a ground station and actually transmit power down to it. So in the same way that, you know, you collect solar power with solar power with traditional panels, with this you'll have a bespoke ground station that forms a connection with a satellite and receives power from space. So where companies like SpaceX have launched a constellation of communication satellites, this would be a constellation of energy satellites.
You're financially backing this, Baiju, obviously with the help of a very successful startup you were co-CEO of previously. What is the funding that will be necessary? Who will you bring on board? How much will this cost?
So right now the company is funded by me, but as we grow the company, you know, we're talking about building a large number of satellites, so it'll take more capital to do that. In terms of the scaling of the business, one of the opportunities that we're looking at in the near term is going to be how can we solve problems that are real on planet Earth today? And the stuff that we're focusing on is how can we deliver power to places that are either contested or difficult to reach? So think military applications like forward deployed bases or things like remote mining applications.
Gotta ask, sounds amazing, but are we talking theoretical physics or are we talking applied physics?
Yeah, so this was one of the core ideas behind this approach, which is we view this as primarily an engineering and economics problem, not a hard science problem. So this is not the sort of company where we're looking to make a breakthrough in science, but rather how can we take technologies that exist today, where even other industries are maturing them, and use those technologies to create something that can happen today?
You will need a launch provider to put you to orbit. What is your relationship with SpaceX, Rocket Lab, the other providers out there?
Yeah, so we're talking to launch providers right now. We're still in the early stages. We're talking to SpaceX, as you mentioned, and we're targeting a launch of our first mission, which will aim to demonstrate this capability Q4 of next year or Q1 the year after.